think I was going through some stuff at that time, and I just was like, I don't deserve to be here voicing this character who is just a ray of sunshine, and everyone looks up to her, and everyone loves her. I just don't belong. I don't belong here. I don't sound pretty enough. That was a thing that I had for a very long time, because I just don't. I don't have that like dog whistle pitch, clear as a bell, voice, and that was a lot of what I heard in anime when I was growing up. You know, and I just was like, I don't have that. I don't know. I don't know if there's really like a place for me here. And so it was, there was just a lot of stuff going on in my head, clearly. And it worked out, but it was one of the most challenging but most rewarding things I've ever done. And I still can't really watch it, because every time I'm crying in that show, I'm actually just sobbing. I would have to, Pat and I, we would have to take breaks.
Actually just crying.
Yeah, and Anohana's the same, actually. We had to take a break. That one, again, was just, we were just like, it was like therapy, you know?
Mm-hmm. So. I never finished Your Lie in April either. I got halfway through and I was like, this is too sad, I can't deal. I'm out.
Very sad, yeah.
Let's see. I would say emotionally, probably Maruki. I still haven't played the game because I'm nervous to like see my performance in, towards the end. But physically, just voice wise, I would have to say Gallo and Promare. I remember we had 2 weeks essentially to get that done. And I had a convention I had to go to, so I was leaving on Thursday. So I had like a week and 3 days. And they were like, dude, this is one of those roles where normally we would just set you up for a 2-hour session every day, and that would be it. But we literally don't have that luxury of time. So it's gonna be like 3 and 4 hour sessions day after day after day. So I remember by the last day that I was in there, because there's usually, most directors will save you from just destroying your voice. So they'll say, hey, this is a really yelly line. We're going to save this to the end of the session, and we'll come back to it at the end. And we just didn't, every single line of Gallo's was just like the most bombastic, just like in your face, scream it to the heavens kind of thing. So there was this, the entire session for 3 hours, 4 hours was just that. And then I remember by the last day that I was in the booth, I had a big water, I had a large throat coat tea with this Chinese loquat honey that all a bunch of voice actors use just when their voice is feeling, like my voice was completely gone, and it was just like, scream a thing, drink water, have tea, chug this loquat honey, okay, next line, here we go. And I remember hearing Johnny Young Bosch do his last battle yell when we have like a big attack, and I was like, oh god, I gotta be on that level. Okay, here we go. So I think that was the hardest thing that I've ever had to do, but it was also one of the most fun things I ever got to do, so no regrets.
No regrets at all. Okay, going to Parabellum 25. Have either of you done much motion capture work? How do you feel about video games moving into integrating more physicality and stage-like acting instead of voiceover?
I love it. I did a little bit of mocap for Spider-Man for Black Cat, and it was such a fun experience. And I mean, Billy and I both come from theater, so being able to move around and actually physicalize, which by the way, like we do often behind the mic do that. I remember when I first started doing voiceover, I almost took out a few Neumanns, like, because I was moving so much. They'd be like, Erica, we love that, but we can't hear you because you're like crouched, like a gremlin. We call it like the gremlin crouch. Legit. Yeah, with Futaba especially. Yeah,
the gremlin.
Yeah, she's gremlin crouching. Like halfway through the session, they have to keep just lowering it at every break. But yeah, like I love it, and I would love to do more of it in the future. I think it's awesome.
Yeah, I haven't actually had the chance to do any mocap, but I've taken classes for mocap stuff, and it makes such a difference just in your read, in your voice. There's something about physically putting yourself in. That just like the way you like, even if like you're just crouching or something like that, it just like makes you be more quiet, or just the way you're turning your head when you do that, it like it sounds different when you physically exert something. So I remember, yeah, I took a few classes at PCB, and they have amazing rigs where it's just attached to your head essentially, and there's like a camera right here and then there's a mic right here, and then you're free to just move around and do stuff. I was like, I kind of want to just make one of those at home and just use that for auditions, because I feel like it would just make your reads kind of pop in a way. But it feels so cool. And again, yeah, coming from a theater background, it feels nice to be able to move around and act off of somebody. It takes a lot of imagination to just be in your booth by yourself and like really convey to the audience that you see these things, you know, and feel these things. So.
Mm-hmm. Okay, going to SD Takashi Wolf here for both.
Hey.
What is one memorable moment that you won't ever forget about your voice acting in general?
Ooh.
I guess it's a memorable booth story, I guess. Most memorable booth story.
I don't know if I have a specific one. Here's my thing is I have a lot of them because when I was doing theater and I would be taking classes, I would see people but just be able to cry on a dime, and I was just like so jealous of that. I was like, how are you doing that? I can never do that. I remember I only cried on stage one time, and that was the last day that I was Aladdin, and I said, I wish for your freedom, genie. That was the only time I cried on stage. But I have cried during animes and video games so often. I don't know what it is about animation. I know I'll never be the same. Shook my world so hard again. Wish I washed away my sins. He's a dead man walking, blank stare.